Now that Dark and Darker is playable again, I've been able to test a few remaining uncertainties regarding the game's damage formula. With those mysteries cleared up, I finally feel confident in presenting exactly what the game's damage formula is. Base damage, plus weapon slash magical damage, multiplied by power bonus, plus additional damage, multiplied by location bonus, damage reduction, and projectile reduction, and finally, plus true damage. Let's break this down bit by bit. First, we start off with our base damage, which is the value shown on a weapon, skill, or spell. Added to this is any instance of weapon damage or magical damage on gear. Right off the bat, there is an exception to this rule. For instances of physical damage that are not direct weapon attacks, weapon damage does not apply. This means that things like Achilles Strike, Rupture, Caltrops, and so on will not benefit from weapon damage bonuses on your gear. Once you've added your base damage and weapon slash magical damage, you then multiply this total by your power bonus. After this, you add any quote-unquote additional physical or magical damage. It's here we see the key difference between weapon damage and additional damage. Additional damage does not benefit from power bonus, however, it will apply to those alternative forms of damage, like Rupture. Because it doesn't benefit from power bonus, it also holds a niche in low strength builds, as additional damage won't be affected by a negative power bonus. Magic users, on the other hand, cannot get magical damage as an enchantment on gear. It only exists on spellbooks and crystal balls. Their only other sources of magic damage are the additional type or the true type, neither of which benefit from power bonus. This means that while casters often have massive magic power bonuses, it doesn't help as much as it would on a physical class. Once you've added up your base and weapon damage, multiplied it by power bonus, and added additional damage, we finally start dealing with universal multipliers. First, we have the location bonus, that is, bonus damage from headshots or negated damage from hitting limbs. When hitting limbs, this multiplier is 50%. For headshots, it's 150% by default, but wearing most headgear will reduce this. The reduction is additive, so wearing a leather cap, for instance, will modify it to become 143%. There are also perks that modify this multiplier, adding 10% with Barbarian's Executioner and 15% for Ranger's Sharpshooter. Once again, this is additive. A leather cap versus an Executioner Barb will result in 153% headshot multiplier. Next, we have damage reduction. This is normally a simple matter of multiplication, but certain abilities can modify this before it activates. For example, armor penetration on gear, Thrust, and Reckless Attack all multiply the enemy's reduction percentage, while Melt will simply subtract a flat 10%. In terms of priority, flat bonuses from Melt, Barricade, Taunt, etc. all apply first, then Weak Points special 50% multiplier, then Armor Penetration. And finally, we have Projectile Reduction. The only way to get this stat is through Plate Armor, the Projectile Resistance perk on Fighter, or as an enchantment on Gear. The stat only applies to projectiles, and what counts as a projectile can be somewhat arbitrary. Arrows, bolts, and throwables are obvious, but a lot of spells are also projectiles. The direct hit portion of Fireball, Magic Missiles, and Ice Bolts are all counted as projectiles, but Zap, Hellfire, and Curse of Pain are not. Once we've multiplied all of that, we can finish things off by adding True Damage. True Damage is unaffected by any other calculations. It doesn't benefit from power bonus or headshots, but also isn't affected by any forms of damage reduction. You can also think of Cleric's Perseverance as a sort of negative true damage, as it subtracts 3 at the end of any damage calculation, although it doesn't seem to be able to reduce damage below 1. And that's that. You now know your damage. Note that in instances of multiple damage sources at once, you need to calculate each individual source individually. For example, hitting with an ignited crystal sword will result in 4 calculations, one for the physical portion of the sword, one for the magical portion, one for the initial ignite damage, and one for the ignite damage over time. Speaking of damage over time, all of these calculations occur at the start of the damage over time, and the end result is simply divided by the number of seconds that the dot lasts. Dots also do benefit from power bonuses, and suffer from damage reductions, so be aware of that when considering whether to bring things like poison weapon. And now, a few random clarifications and fun facts. First is that with early access came the introduction of a new mechanic. There's no official name for this, but it's effectively a forced scaling on bonus damage that only applies to certain portions of certain skills. How it works is that your bonus damage, be it weapon or additional, and your power bonus are all individually cut in half before the damage calculation is run. One skill with this scaling is Achilles Strike, or specifically, the damage when you take a step part of Achilles Strike. If you were to calculate this damage with the +5 physical damage from Axe Specialist, it would look something like this. These are all of the skills we know of so far that carry this new restriction. Another thing of note is the fact that just about every single perk that claims to give bonus damage in the game is actually just adding that number to your power bonus. Back Attack, Ambush, Blunt Weapon Mastery, Arcane Mastery, Combo Attack, the list goes on. This can make some perks slightly misleading in their effectiveness. The two-hander perk boosts your power by 5%, which may make you assume that it's making you do 5% more damage, but in reality, Barbarian starts with 115% physical damage already, so the bonus is actually a net benefit of 4.3%. This also means that the bonus damage perks for Rogue and Ranger are more impactful than you might think, as these classes start with very low physical power. Worth noting is that these bonuses are all additive with each other. Think of the increased logic in Path of Exile. Ambush, Back Attack, and Weak Point combined would add 130% to Rogue's already existing power bonus, rather than all being multiplied separately. And while we're talking about physical power, a common question that is asked is whether weapon damage, physical power, or additional damage is the best idea. The answer is, it depends. But generally, the logic goes as such. If you already have positive physical power bonus, then each individual point of weapon damage will be more impactful than an individual point in any other stat. Take Barbarian, for instance. They have a 115% multiplier on their weapon damage, meaning that each point of weapon damage is effectively 1.15 points of damage. The game does keep track of decimal damage and health, so this is important. Because of this, point for point, weapon damage will be the most impactful for Barbarian's damage. The exception is in the case of external physical damage, such as Achilles Strike. Sure, weapon damage will be impactful on all of your weapon swings, but it will not affect the damage dealt by Achilles. If you're trying to build around a particular skill like this, then additional damage is your best bet. Additional damage is also a good idea if your power bonus is in the negative. Additional damage doesn't benefit from power bonus, but it also isn't hurt by negative power bonus, so it's technically more useful than weapon damage if you're a low strength class like Ranger or Cleric. And to cap off the damage type comparison, strength is also a very important consideration. Strength gives physical power inherently, meaning that it does add to your damage, even if it's not as significant as weapon damage if your physical power is already above zero. But it also gives HP, meaning that it not only increases your damage, but also increases your survivability. It's for this reason that strength is often a top priority, no matter what class you play. Another random odd perk with this system is what exactly is affected by limb and headshot multipliers. Whether something does or doesn't seems entirely arbitrary. For example, Cleric Smite, Wizard's Ignite, and Warlock's Blow of Corruption all add an instance of magical damage to their physical attacks. But for some reason, Ignite and Blow of Corruption benefit from headshots, while Smite does not. Even jankier is the fact that Ignite's Afterburn benefits from headshots as well. And that should give you a pretty solid foundation to work with when it comes to the game's damage calculations. If there are any major changes to the system, there will be an update in the comments, or possibly a new version of this video. Sadly, a lot of in-game perk and skill descriptions are often vague, misleading, or downright incorrect, so if you want more accurate descriptions, be sure to check out the Dark and Darker wiki.